So you mentioned you used the term pilot. I'm assuming that ties into the provisional program that I've seen you guys talking about. So what's the objective of the provisional program? How long will that be in effect? How many folks do you think auditors or audit organizations do you think would be part of that? You know, what is the gate for somebody to participate in that program if they're listening and they are interested in participating in that program?
I love your question, John. I think it's a great question. So the provisional program is the one where we're going to use a limited number of assessors, mm-hmm. going to train them and work with them directly to learn from, you know, based on what we have already developed. And we have processes and methodologies that we've developed in draft form that are not publicized yet, but there's a lot that's been developed, a lot of amazing documents. I mean, I looked through some of the documentation that is currently not public at all, but that is internal to the AB about, you know, the support to assessors in terms of, you know, all kinds of criteria and methodologies and so forth. So there's a lot that's been developed. I think it's amazing. And I'm just amazed. I'm just a training guy, but I'm just amazed at how much work has been done by 15 people who are doing this as volunteers and also industry working groups that work with them. And I'm in awe of how much commitment there is. However, they're all in draft form. And so we then need to take these documents and that are practices, methodologies, or, and actually put them to use and use them in the real world using these pilot programs. And that's really what this provisional program is about. And hopefully learn from them. There's also the rulemaking that's happening in the DoD, and they're really kind of right now spending a lot of time really integrating CMMC into their processes and creating some rules and DFARS rules about that. And so those are going to come out. So those details, once they come out, along with us testing our methodology and our criteria documentation, I think all of that hopefully will be done through the provisional program. And we're going to use a select number of assessors that we train, and then we use pilot programs and pilot contracts that the DoD selects, and we would go through these assessments and hopefully learn from them. And that will take us through to late this year, early next year timeframe, where we will have better understanding of our documents. You know, that's the goal of the provisional program. At the end of that, we will have a better understanding of our documents and ensure that they work in the real world. The DoD will have completed their rulemaking process and integrated CMMC into the DFARS, and which, by the way, might your listeners may not know, it's the DoD Federal Acquisition Regulations, and I don't know what the S stands for. So you know, and on the other side, we'll come out wiser, more experienced, and ready for the large scale program that would ensue.